Hello everyone, and welcome to Natural English. This is a little session that I'm going to do for you guys so I can try and help you speak more like a native would. Okay, I decided to call this Natural English. If you take a look at the picture here, I want you to imagine yourself talking to those people. How would you sound like? What would you say? So that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be talking a little bit more naturally. Now, like I said, I'm not going to be a good teacher. The things I teach you will be what we really say, not what's in your textbooks. So hopefully you can take a look at my PowerPoint, and this video will help you and show you some of the differences between what a textbook would have in the way of being more formal and doing things like really properly and everything, not really what happens in daily life. Okay? Well, anyway, here we go. Let's get started about natural English. Who am I? What should you say? Who am I? One more time. Who am I? That's right. You need to practice. My name is Carl Atnip. I come from America, and I teach oral English, oral phrases, and academic culture. I'm sorry, and American culture. I've been teaching for 5 years in Taiwan. I recently got married and moved to Taiwan, so I know what it's like to speak another language and then have somebody tell you, you need to speak English. Right. That's gonna work. No, it doesn't work too well. Not when you're having to speak another language and you don't want to. So if you want to know another language, there's a lot of information out there on the web. I'm not saying that it's not valid. Everything, every little bit of information is gonna help you. So just wanna let you know this is what my part is, just to kind of give you an idea. So this is called Natural English, and my name is Carl. Alright, natural English. What is natural English? And natural English basically means real life English. And how do we do this? We do this by being not formal, okay? Your books are going to teach you the formal way of speaking English. And what that is like saying, hello, how are you? Nice to meet you. Thank you. Goodbye. But if that's all you know, people don't speak like, you need to understand, people don't speak like this in the real world. Listen to me. People don't speak like that. Do you hear me speaking like this? No. That's because we don't. Your books do. That's because it's easy for the authors to write, not for them to express. That's why video is the great communicator. Yes. So anyway, the second rule of natural English is to use small sentences. A small sentence is better than a long sentence that does not make sense. Okay, so if you can speak small, simple English, it's a lot better than having a long sentence that no one understands. Okay, simple English is better than bad English. Okay? Simple is better. And next thing you need to know is, of course, practice. Don't just practice with me. Get a webcam or look in a mirror. Okay? Look in a mirror. Talk to yourself. And that's why I like webcam, because it's kind of funny. You can play it back and listen to yourself and see how you sound. You also have a microphone on your website. And it may help to get some headphones if you want to do some Skype sessions or something like that. Please get some headphones with a microphone, okay? Just to let you know. And of course, practice means to repeat again, 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 okay? Repeat, repeat, repeat. Over and over again I know when I was learning Chinese, I had to speak, I had to repeat myself at least 20 times before I can even come close to a natural English speaker or a natural Chinese speaker. It is very difficult to learn a language. I will not tell you that this is easy, and it requires work. Okay? So if you're ready, let's continue. Okay, our next one is to basically introduce ourselves. Now, your book says, "Hello, my name is." Oh, how wonderful. And then if you go to America or go to an English-speaking country, we don't say that. And you're like, "Why? It's in the book." Uh-oh, what do you do now? No. We don't say, "My name is." Well, we do, but we only do it sparingly. And we do it very formally for only people we do not know. If you do not know them, then you can say this. But if you know them already, we know who you are. Don't say that. You sound stupid when you do this. Okay? You sound stupid when you say, "Hello, my name is." Okay? You sound like a robot. Or like the stupid kid in the back of the classroom. Gets stuff thrown at him. Okay? That's so stupid. Say, "I'm." "Hello, I'm." Like, "I'm John." Or, "I'm Nick." "I'm Sally." "I'm Tina." "I'm John." For example, "I'm Carl. Nice to meet you." Our next one is you can say, "Call me." You say, "Call me Carl." Most people do. That's another way of saying, "Hello, my name is." Call me. Not just call me, like on a telephone. But call me Carl, or call me John, or Mary, or Jane, or Joseph. It's all the same. And the third one is not very common, but sometimes you may hear it from strangers that you don't know. Again, some people don't like to say, "Hello, my name is." They say, "People call me. People call me Edward," but you can say Ed or Eddie. "People call me Edward," but you can say Ed or Eddie. Yeah, it sounds more better. And like I say, sometimes English has a lot of rules, and I'm sorry, but sometimes you just need to have a foreigner tell you that it sounds stupid. Okay, if it sounds stupid, it sounds stupid. There's no other way you're going to know. Okay, I'm here to tell you the truth. It sounds stupid when you say, "My name is." Okay, it sounds like you're a robot. Don't do this. Say, "I'm." You're more safe. Okay, or call me. "I'm John." Or call me John. Or sometimes people call me Nick. But you can say, "Nikki." Practice that. Alright? At least 10 times. Sorry, 10. 5 times. 10 times. Practice that. Okay? I'm going to leave that slide up for just a little bit. You can go back and pause the video. But we're going to continue on. Next one is if you want to get someone's attention, like if someone's walking down the street, like you saw in our first one, in our first slide, if you're going down the street in the middle of a busy intersection, it's loud. People don't hear you. You need to get their attention. Like if you need a police officer, or if you need an ambulance, or you need some directions. You're lost. You don't know where you are. How do you get someone's attention? So that's what we're going to talk about. Getting attention. You say, "Yo! Yo!" People understand. "What? What do you want?" Or, "Hey! Hey!" Okay? "Hey! Are you there? You there?" Or, "Excuse me?" "Excuse me" is a little bit the polite way, like it says in your book. "Excuse me. Excuse me." Yeah. "Excuse me." Okay? "You're in my way. Move. Move." thank you. Yes, thank you. Okay? And if you're really into it and you come to America, you'll hear people say, hey, man! Hey, man! Okay? Or ma'am, if you are a lady. Ma'am. Men and ma'am, if you're a woman. So another way to get people's attention. Take a look at the screen and practice these, okay? At least 10 times. You need to practice. If you don't, well, the fault's on you, because I'm here to help you, but you have to practice too, okay? And take a look at our last one, saying thank you and goodbye. Okay, you want to say thank you and goodbye, like your book says, thank you, bye-bye. No. Okay, it's not, it's not the same. We don't say that, all right? You look like an idiot, and you sound like, you sound stupid again. Again, it sounds stupid. Say thanks. Okay? Thanks. Say it one more time. Thanks. Yeah. Again. Thanks. That's what most people use. Or you can say, great. I appreciate that. It means the same thing. Great. I appreciate it. Bye. Okay? It means thank you. But it's a more engaging experience. It means something that comes from here. It means you're excited that someone did something for you. Not just saying, thank you. Thank you. No. No. It's not going to work. People are going to look at you like you're stupid. Okay? That's what I'm here to tell you. Maybe I'm not a good teacher, but these books suck. Okay? They're going to teach you what the formal English method is. And usually that comes from Oxford, okay? Oxford English. We are not British, first off. We are American. We speak, like, completely different ways. Even though it's the same English language, but the way we say things is completely different. And we have, oh, wow, that's cool. So if you think America is better, you say, oh, wow, that's cool. You're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome. That's cool. Okay, say it again. That's cool. That's cool. And then, of course, you have the old, you have the last one. And these kind of depend on how you say them. Okay, how you say them makes a difference. Saying thanks is kind of like, okay, thanks. But you say, thanks. That means like, wow, you did something really special for me. And if you say, yeah, that's kind of like, yeah. Like you got an A on your exam. Or your teacher said, you did a good job. You say, yeah. Okay. If you say, yeah. It means like, oh, it means like you really appreciate someone for doing something for you. Like if you have a new family or if you get married or something like that. It's a really, really special, a really special way of saying thank you. It's like, yeah. Okay. It's like a bond. It's like a family bond. When you say that, it's very heartfelt. And the last one is, if you don't give a shit. If you really don't care, and you just want to kind of say thank you, and whatever. Just say, okay. Alright? Yeah, okay. I don't care. Well, okay. For example, your boss may give you some extra work, and you gotta, like, say something, right? So just say, okay. Yeah, bye. Basically means the same thing. It means okay. It means thanks. Okay? Or thank you. And of course, we don't say bye-bye. No. We say bye. Or laters. Let me put that in there because I know you're going to forget it. Oops. If I can make a mark here. Okay. Your book will say, see you later. Yeah? But that equates to laters. There we go. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So that equates to laters. If you say laters, it's kind of like you're speaking normal. You're speaking more normal American English. Just laters. All right. Bye. So I hope this has been informative. I will try my best to help you out as much as I can. Like I say, leave comments in the comments below, and I will try to get back to you, okay? And please feel free to hit me up on Skype or Google Plus. All right, let me know what you think. Anyway, real American English, a little bit different than your books. All right, bye.